So the Galaxy S25 Ultra is set to feature the new Snapdragon 8 Elite chipset, which Qualcomm just unveiled at their latest event. And it's now official, Apple no longer has the fastest smartphone chip. The crown is now on the Android side, and that's a big deal for the S25 Ultra. Let's dive into 7 major things Qualcomm revealed and what they mean for Samsung's next flagship. What's up guys, Sal here. So let's start with the big one. Samsung's CEO was at the event confirming that the S25 series will use the Snapdragon 8 Elite chipset. So what's new with the chip? First up, it's built on TSMC's advanced 3-nanometer process and comes with Ryzen cores instead of the usual Cortex Prime cores. And they're clocked at an insane 4.32 GHz. What does that mean? We're looking at a 45% boost in CPU performance and 44% better power efficiency compared to last year's Snapdragon 8 Gen 3. That's a massive upgrade. But let's talk benchmarks. Qualcomm shared some numbers, and they're pretty impressive. The Snapdragon 8 Elite in a reference device scored 3,221 in single core and 10,426 in multi-core tests on Geekbench 6. For comparison, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 in the S24 Ultra scored 2,300 and 7,200 in the same tests. Even better, the single core score is almost neck and neck with Apple's iPhone 16 Pro Max, which hit 3,300, but the Snapdragon 8 Elite's multi-core score is 26% higher than Apple's. On the graphics side, Qualcomm has really upped their game with a revamped Adreno GPU. It delivers a 40% boost in performance and the same improvement in power efficiency. In tests like 3D Mark Wildlife Unlimited, the Snapdragon 8 Elite pushed an average of 159 frames per second, a solid 28% increase from the S24 Ultra. It even beats the iPhone 16 Pro Max, which managed just 107 FPS. If you're into gaming, this is big news. Speaking of games, Qualcomm also introduced Unreal Engine's Nanite Tech, which brings console-quality 3D environments to mobile games. This means mobile gaming is about to get a lot more serious with film-quality graphics right on your phone. And if you're wondering, can this chip handle AAA games? The answer is a resounding yes. The Realme phone using the Snapdragon 8 Elite was seen running Assassin's Creed Black Flag, a pretty demanding console game at a smooth 60 FPS. Sure, it's an older game, but it's still impressive. Even crazier, the GPU was only using 70% of its power, so there is a lot of room for even more demanding games. And just to clarify, this isn't your average mobile game with downgraded graphics, we're talking the full console version of the game with no compromises in quality. With this chipset now supporting AAA games, it's only a matter of time before more console-level games make their way to devices like the S25 Ultra. Moving on to AI, Qualcomm has made some significant improvements here too. The Snapdragon 8 Elite performs AI tasks 45% faster than the 8 Gen 3. One of the coolest new features is an AI-powered video object eraser that runs entirely on the device. On the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3, you had to upload your video to the cloud to use this feature, which is probably why Samsung didn't enable it on the S24 Ultra. But now that it's all happening on device, we can expect this feature to show up on the S25 Ultra. Now here's a fun bit about software support. Qualcomm says the Snapdragon 8 Elite will be supported with 8 years of Android OS updates. But hold up, it doesn't mean every phone with this chip will get 8 years of updates. The smartphone companies still have to roll them out. Samsung already offers 7 years of updates for the S24 series, and I don't expect that to change with the S25. What else? The Snapdragon 8 Elite also comes with a built-in ultra-wideband chip. This means phone makers no longer need to add a separate chip for ultra-wideband, which is great news. It's likely that even the base Galaxy S25 model will have the ultra-wideband this time, something we haven't seen before. Finally, let's talk about the camera. The Snapdragon 8 Elite has AI deeply integrated into its image processing, which allows for real-time AI-based enhancements while you're snapping photos or shooting video. One standout feature is that AI assistants will now be able to see what you see through the camera in real-time, meaning you can ask questions or get info about objects you're filming. And the best part? All this processing happens directly on the device, so no cloud needed. So to sum it up, the Snapdragon 8 Elite is one of the biggest upgrades we've seen in smartphone chips in a long time. The Galaxy S25 Ultra is shaping up to be an absolute powerhouse, and this chipset is a big reason why. If you want to catch more updates on the S25 Ultra, click right here and I'll see you there.